Hello Taurus, Taurus Rising, and Taurus Moon people. This is your weekly astrological and card forecast for the week starting January 30th, 2017. And a quick reminder for you guys, when I say moon and rising, I do mean check your moon and rising. That's kind of just my way of paraphrasing that in there. Gives an extra dimension to your horoscope if you know what those signs are, and it will help for a more personalized, general horoscope for you. However, if you do want something more unique to you and your specific chart or your specific situation, of course, you can always go to my website, integrativemysticism.com. I'll just drop a card there. So what is going on with your astrology this week? Well, this week, it's all about Mercury. Mercury is actually doing the same thing it did back in December, and it's actually going to be forming a bit of a T-square to Jupiter and Uranus at the same time. And this is between your ninth house of travel, higher education, permits, government, legal proceedings, broadcasting. It's going to be T-squaring Jupiter in your sixth house of work and schedule, and it's going to be also hitting Uranus in your 12th house of your past, your privacy, and your hidden zone. And the big angle that is sort of the repeat from December is that we are getting put on the spot. Everyone's getting put on the spot in some fashion or in some capacity this week, but for you, it's not necessarily a bad thing. Because being put on the spot could very well mean that this could be an opportunity for you to finally take a big test or retake a big test to get some kind of certification, some kind of authorization, some kind of leeway, some kind of big green light go-ahead with a career plan or an educational path or even a big travel opportunity you've been looking for. In fact, usually when you have Jupiter and Uranus involved in the same time, we may be talking about, again, the opportunity to take a trip of a lifetime, maybe even getting some traveling abroad at least planned out this week, or at least on the table, at least committed to it. We may not get on a plane this week, but it is on the table for you. This is also especially nice because a lot of you Taurus people are getting a second chance with whatever this is this week. It could be, again, dream job, dream education, or even a dream trip. So make sure that you are available and ready to at least entertain the thought. So what is going on with your cards this week? Well, for your spiritual advice, we do have the card of the Fairy Godmother. And she's not the same Fairy Godmother as you would think in like a fairy tale. The Fairy Godmother does, again, put us on the spot. We're saying that a lot this week, I think. And when we talk about the Fairy Godmother in this deck, we are talking about somebody who is basically orchestrating, or something is going to be orchestrated for you, something that you can't avoid. Now, this could show up in relationships, this could show up in business, this could show up even with your personal health, your home life, but when you pay attention to what doors are opening and closing over and over and over again, but we keep making the same decision of walking away from the options that are being presented to us, the Fairy Godmother is just going to make sure it just gets rubbed in our face. So it's like, I'm trying to steer you towards something very, very nice, something's going to be very good for you, and you might not choose it on any other day, but if you could trust me, that would be great. And this could, again, be an opportunity you don't think you're available for, and that's a huge theme of this week. What do you not think you're available for that is being offered to you that you should take? For your Earth sector, when it comes to your work and finances, we have the Six of Wands upright. Beautiful card for work and finances because the Six of Wands always talks about a big victory, some kind of popularity, possibly even somebody singing your praises and promoting you. And this might not even be an official promotion in terms of status, though usually with the Six of Wands we have that coming soon as well. But this could also indicate some kind of a raise, some kind of maybe even public acknowledgement coming through your work and your efforts. This is definitely a big resume booster, and for those of you looking for a new job, the Six of Wands upright says we absolutely have some offers to entertain this week that will pan out. So if you're getting sick and tired of a job hunt, if you're getting sick and tired of a job search, this is absolutely the kind of card you want to get. Sorry, my cat is just being weird today. For your communications with air, when it comes to your friends, your relatives, and the others in your life, we do have the Six of Cups upright. And this week is talking about actually getting back in touch with your past. This may actually be an old friend or a relative that we've become estranged from. In fact, the Six of Cups upright could indicate this is somebody we haven't actually seen nor heard from in a while, But, you know, sometimes we get along without them okay, and then when we meet them and we see them again, we realize how much they were missing from our space. Definitely feeling more like a platonic relationship, so I don't want anyone to think this probably doesn't feel like a love relationship. Still an important one nonetheless that you should be ready to welcome. For your challenge this week with fire, we do have the Four of Wands upright. And the Four of Wands is interesting because the Four of Wands kind of talks about a challenge that doesn't really exist. In fact, with the Four of Wands upright, the only challenge that we normally have is being able to understand that even if we're not feeling like we're in the mood to socialize, we're not in the mood to kind of get in touch with people, we're not in the mood to go out, we need to make ourselves go out. You may be finding out that, yeah, there's a bit of a friend group reunion going on, or there's an after-work party happening, and for some reason you're really being told that you need to go to this event, you do need to go to this thing. Your challenge is to make sure that you absolutely do, because you never know, there always is some kind of extra thing that comes out after hours with people that could be incredibly vital or just incredibly enjoyable to you also, you know. So even if you don't think it's going to be a good time, this week you have to make yourself go, and you won't regret it. For your emotions with water and your romantic life, we do have the Hierophant card upright. And this card is a very, very good sign for those of you Taurus people who are looking to become official, those of you who are trying to reach that maybe even Facebook official status. Whew. Now, because with the Hierophant card, we are talking about making some kind of pact, making some kind of agreement with a crush or even with a partner that does sort of add an extra layer to that lovely umbrella term people like to call commitment. And the reason I say it that way is because there's so many better words than commitment. Commitment is something we hide behind. Anyway, I'm off the soapbox. The Hierophant card does actually speak of, again, making some kind of plan cemented and official, though. And so even if you're currently coupled, or you're currently partner, you're already married, whatever you're looking for, if you and your partner have yet to actually sit down and set something in stone you need to do, whether it's, again, we want to have a child, we want to move, we want to move in together, anything along those lines that's been sort of just floating up in the air for too long and needs to become grounded and secure, this is the week where we start actually getting that underway. So that is your forecast, Taurus. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like, share, and subscribe. You know I appreciate it. And of course, if you'd like to get a session, you can always follow the links below or go to integrativemysticism.com.